Here's how you can stay in charge. Have your written set of goals with you at all times. Then prioritize your goals and decide which is important. Then have your goals match up to a good written game plan. The game plan that says, take it out of your head and put it down on paper. Then, with game plan in hand, try to separate the majors from the minors. The really important things from the things you just have to do. Is this a major day or a minor day? And adjust your time accordingly. Is this a major conversation or a minor conversation? A lot of people don't do well, and here's why. They major in minor things. They spend too much time on things that don't count, and too little time on things that should count. If it's a minor call, a few pleasantries will probably do, so a little evaluation will save you a lot of time. Major, minor. Don't mistake movement for achievement. You probably know some people around you who are just plain busy being busy. You've got to be busy being productive. It's easy to get faked out by being busy. Guy comes home at night, says, I've been going, going, going. But the real question is, doing what? That's the real key, not the going, going, going. Some people are going, 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 doing figure eights. They're not making much progress. Evaluate the hours in your days and see if there's not a lot of wasted time in there that you could manage better. Focus. You've just got to zero in on the job at hand. Concentrate. I used to start my business day in the shower. I'm trying to compose a letter in the shower. I'm not awake yet, and I'm trying to compose a letter. Found out it doesn't work. Wait till you get to the office to start your work. Don't start your business day at the breakfast table. It's not good for the family. On the way to work, don't think about work. It's dangerous. Can you imagine if everybody was driving to work thinking about work? It'd be a mess. Here's what you've got to do. On the way to work, concentrate on the way. In the shower, concentrate on the shower. At the breakfast table, concentrate on the family. Wherever you are, be there. Give whatever you're doing the gift of attention. Gift of attention. Concentration. Next time management essential, learn to say no. Boy, it's easy in a social society to just say yes, yes, yes too much. Over-obligate yourself. Don't say yes too quickly. Better to say, I don't know if I can make it, but I'll give you a call. Better to say you don't know than to say yes, 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 trying to be nice and then having to back out. Don't let your mouth overload your back. Committing too soon, too quick. Appreciate yourself, your time. Know when your commitment to someone else will end up taking time away from yourself and from your family. Have self-appreciation for your special time alone and those who love you. A group of entrepreneurs I know have been very successful in their business. Pretty soon they're swamped with requests to do pro bono work. They must get a couple of offers a month to sit in on one charity board or another. But here's how they handle it. They take all requests, weigh them for time commitments, then they take a collective vote on which two they'll accept during the next 12 months. You can't immediately say yes to offers that sound prestigious. You can't immediately say yes to social functions. You've got to say maybe. And take time to evaluate what's an important contribution to society, what'll just take time away from your ambitions and your family. Be eager to please yourself and your family. Don't be so eager to please everybody else. You don't have to fill up every second of the day. Take time to appreciate what you've accomplished. Your success should be a pleasure. Appreciating what you've got and what you've done and who you've become is important. Just knowing that you've accomplished in one day what you laid out in your game plan. Just knowing that you finished all you started out to do that day. That's encouraging. Let's say you're figuring out tomorrow's game plan tonight, and tomorrow looks pretty light. So all you write down for tomorrow is cleanup day. You know, clean up all the little notes on your desk. Take care of a few phone calls that keep getting shuffled from one day to the next. Just minor stuff. Little stuff that keeps nagging on you until you get it done. Not a major day, but at the end of the day, you feel you've accomplished so much. Why? Because you've taken care of so many little details. You feel like you've really achieved something during this day that started out to be so minor. Little achievements are just as important as big achievements, because you can't appreciate the big achievements without first appreciating the little ones. Because so often we find ourselves racing to get ahead that we can't appreciate the time in between. Happiness is not in the getting. Happiness is in the becoming. Happiness is a joy that most comes as a result of positive activity. Happiness is both the joy of discovery and the joy of knowing. It's the result of an awareness of the full range of life, experiences, sounds, dreams, goals. And it's the joy that comes from designing a life. Happiness is being able to explore all that life offers. Happiness is quite often found in having options. Options of doing what you want to instead of doing what you have to. Happiness is receiving and sharing. Happiness is found in taking time to enjoy what you've accomplished, in giving yourself credit when credit is due. Happiness is here and now. Happiness isn't the end result. Happiness is part of the journey. The road to heaven is heaven. The happiness that you're searching for in the future must be found today. Success is the balance between the need for active achievement and the satisfaction in taking the time to acknowledge what you've already achieved. And while you're reflecting back on your past accomplishments, think about something else. Think about the potential within you that's still untapped. What could I have achieved in the past had I been more diligent? Could I have been more disciplined, worked smarter instead of harder? What could I have achieved in the past had I tried a little differently? Only you can answer this question. All I'm asking is that you dig a little deeper and see if you can't be a bit more effective next time. Work a little smarter instead of a little harder. So that's question number one. What could I have achieved in the past? Now here's number two. How can I achieve more in the future? Do you need to work more diligently? Do you need to be more disciplined? Do you need to work smarter instead of harder? Do you need to manage your time better? You can put down on paper what worked for you in the past and figure out ways to translate this information into the future. You can face your future with more excitement, more anticipation, when you design a future worth getting excited about. But don't forget to appreciate yourself for what you have done so far. Take a self-appreciation inventory. Ask yourself a few questions. What have I achieved in the last 4 days, the last 2 weeks, the last year, the last 10 years? What have I achieved during these time periods? Write it down. Take inventory of yourself. Now compare this list to your goals. Have you accomplished all you set out to do in the last 4 days, 1 year, 10 years? Compare your list. Maybe you've been so busy trying to reach your goals that you haven't taken the time to sit back and reflect on where you've really been. Look back at your list and say, "Wow, I really have learned a lot. Look what I've done. Look what I've become. I wasn't like this 10 years ago or even 1 year ago. Look at me. I'm doing okay."